Keith Kidwell, resident of Chocowinity. Well, my mailing address is Chocowinity. I'm actually outside of the city limits. I echo what Mr. Caton said. I'd also like to point out, in the questions that people ask realtors, they're typically asking the school zone that they're in, they're asking what the real estate taxes are. I can't recall anybody ever asking, what jail district are you in? It just doesn't happen, okay? It's not the type of thing that's going to attract business. It's not the type of thing that's going to attract new residents to Chocowinity. So I don't see any sense in that. The other thing I want to point out, if you follow the commissioners' meetings, at the last commissioners' meeting, a lady stood up and said that there was about 200 people in Beaufort County who had signed a petition speaking against the need of a jail at this time, and most particularly in Chocowinity. In fact, the people that have signed the petition is well over 600. Point being there is, out of everybody that's been approached to sign these petitions, there's only been a very minuscule amount that says, no, I don't want to sign it. Okay? Most everybody has wanted to sign it. I spent out several hours not this past weekend, the one before, talking to the citizens of Chocowinity and talking to folks outside of the Food Lion. Inevitably, the answer I got when I said, ladies and gentlemen, here's a flyer that tells you a little bit about what they're trying to do with building a new jail in Chocowinity, the response was, what? What fool would want to do that? And that was exact quotes. Another guy said, do what? And I was like, exactly, that's the way I feel. No one, out of the hundreds of people that we spent, three or four of us out there, several hours, no one thought it was a good idea to build the jail. In Chocowinity in particular. Okay? So you are the influential people in this county, otherwise you wouldn't be sitting where you are, or in this city, I should say. We would ask, I think, as a group, and you know, maybe a show of hands, who's against the jail in Chocowinity? Okay, so we pretty much all feel the same way if you use that as a poll. You ladies and gentlemen are sitting there as the people who can influence the building or not building of this jail at this particular location. And I think everybody here would ask, or just about everybody would ask, that you go against that instead of for it. Thank you for your time.
Anyone else?
Yeah, me. My name's Sharon Buck, for those of you that don't know me.
I do.
Where the jail is supposed to be being placed is desperately going to affect my property. I have an 18-acre farm that's going to butt right up against it. Will I ever be able to put a housing development out there which Chocowinity desperately needs? Not now. Not if it goes out there. I will not be able to. I know other people's homes are closer than mine are, but it's going to desperately affect me. As far as my taxes, I know it's going to go up. They can tell me what they want to, but I know my taxes are going to go up. My property value is going to go down. And I would ask each one of y'all, would y'all want a jail next to your home? And I know that answer's got to be no. Nor do we, the ones that live out there. And like he says, y'all are the voices of Chocolate. Residents. I do live outside, but I support you. And I'd like y'all to seriously, seriously think about what they're getting ready to do. Thank you.
And just to inform this group a bit, the planning board's role in this function or in the amendment process is to make recommendation to the town board. They can't vote yea or nay for the jail. They can vote yea or nay for the recommendation on the amendment language to forward it to the commissioners, but at this time, that's their ability in this process is to make recommendation, whether it be favorable or not recommend the amendment language is going to be the job of this board, our responsibility of this board. So just wanted to kind of inform the group of that process as well. Now, this is the chairman here that is.
How is the town of Chocowinity going to benefit by putting this jail over here?
So
The only really benefit is the sewer revenue, but, I mean, really, I mean, we haven't even gotten an application in yet, so, I mean, we really have nothing to really look at right now.
So, just the sewer revenue would basically...
That would be the only thing, the real revenue, so we really get.
Versus if I put a housing development out there, the revenue that you would draw off that housing development would be a whole lot more.
You wouldn't have sewer in that development.
No, but you'd have property on it.
You're outside the town limits. So we wouldn't get any...
That'd be county, wouldn't it? That'd be county.
We could absolutely not.
So it's only the sewer situation.
Yeah, Michael Sharp here. I've driven around the counties, all the county around here, and I see these jails around, and I'm imagining one in our backyard here in Chappewinty. I own some property in Chappewinty too. But the optics of having a federal prison here with all the just the wire around it, I mean, do we really want that for Chappewinty? And the other question is, have there been any studies at all on the impact that these prisons have had in the other communities? And I think that should be part of any evaluation before you decide to put it here. But I can't imagine the optics of barbed wire fences and razor wire around the place in Chappewinty.
Thank you for your comments.
Anyone else? We're giving you an opportunity. This wasn't scheduled, but we're doing this.
I'd like to speak. My name is Garrett Blunt. I live down on Blunt's Creek Road. I spent the weekend communicating to the residents of Beaufort County down on the Price Road, the Hardy Road, and the Gray Road, in reference to this jail. And to my surprise, there was a whole lot of people that I spoke to, property owners, that didn't even really know what was going on. I understand that Mr. Buck, what he's saying, that this planning board, they just make recommendations. So I would ask that the planning board make a recommendation in reference to reaching out to the citizens in Beaufort County on those particular roads. I don't know what the limit is, if it's outside of Chappewinty jurisdiction or if it's in the county, I'm not really sure. But for the folks that I spoke to, they was really surprised in the amount of how much the county, and I know that doesn't have anything to do with the planning board, that's the county commission in reference to borrowing the money, but they were still surprised and amazed to the amount of money that's going to be borrowed. Also, that nobody had reached out to them, you know, personally to get their opinion on what they thought about a jail being right at their back door. So that would just be my only, you know, opinion. My advice would be is, someone reach out to the residents on the Price Road, on the Hardy Road, and on the Gray Road to specifically let them know exactly what's going on, because there's two daycares, one on 33 and then one on the Gray Road. I spoke to the daycare owner on the Gray Road, and she was surprised that, you know, that the county would be considered, or Chappewinty itself would be considering putting a jail that close, as well as the school is right down the road. But that would be my comment, and thank you for your time.
Sure. Anyone else?
I would like to say something. I'm Cindy Haddock. Of course, I've lived here for the last 35 years. But, and this property is, my house is exactly where, right on the line, where the $4 million rest area is going to be built. And right across the road from that is where you're talking about putting the jail. I can't imagine that the state of North Carolina would even consider not doing something to stop that, because why would you put a $4 million rest area in an area right across the road from a 250-bed jail? I mean, it just doesn't make sense. You know, not to mention the fact that, you know, you're looking at just the sewer to as income. We don't know exactly how much we're talking about as far as dollars are concerned, and is it worth people in coming into this county or into this town and in the surrounding areas where you would get more revenue by building businesses and the whole area populating more. With the rest area there, personally, I think that's ridiculous. But that's done. Hasn't been built yet, but it's pretty much done. But the jail, that makes absolutely no sense. I mean, it's here we are looking at the town of Chocolinity coming in on 17, and you've got this really nice rest area over here, and you've got a prison over here. I mean, who's going to want to stop there? That's a waste of money. Total waste of money. And Sharon, you're exactly right. Our property values are going to go right down the tubes. And is anybody going to reimburse us for that? I mean, I've got, Charles and I have 45 acres there. Who's going to pay us for our value of our property? Yeah, that's all I've got to say about that. I mean, you know, just for food for thought.
Thank you, Ms. Hatter.
I think what everybody's trying to say is we know that we don't live in the city, just like you said, but we are in the county, and we're going to look to y'all appreciatively if y'all go to bat for us that are in the county, because we don't live in the city. But you are our county.
Cindy, and my property is in the ETJ of Chocolinity also, so that's something that really affects us. You know, if we wanted to do a subdivision, we've looked at that as a possibility down the road. And it's probably, last time I had someone look at it, we're looking at 30 to 35 houses next door to the property that would be on the east side of 17. You know, and that's something that would just kill that. Who would ever want to do that? Plus, there's a lot of land right in that area for potential residential development. That's right down the wind. That's down to two as far as that. Not only our property, but others in the area the same way. And that is in your ETJ.
Anything else?
I just thank everyone for coming out and having your voices heard by the planning board. You're welcome at any of these meetings. All of these are public meetings. Again, I just would reiterate to share these and express your concerns with the town board of commissioners. They will be the ones to inevitably make the final decision on the amendment language. Putting something in the ordinance, mechanism in the ordinance regarding a jail or a correctional facility. So, and again, I do thank each and every one of you honestly for being here this evening.
Okay. We stand adjourned. Doesn't require a motion.